honored luminary, shall we proceed?
They're incredible.
They tell a tale as old as Arborea itself. The tale of the Luminary, a child chosen by mighty Yggdrasil, one sent to save us from disaster. Our friend here is not the first to be known by that name. No. The first was born long, long ago in the Age of Heroes. At that time, the world of Erdrea was beset by a being of purest darkness. A being who sought to steal the very source of life itself, the heart of Yggdrasil. And so, the World Tree marked out one among her children for greatness. Erdwin. The luminary of legend. He went forth to do battle with the Dark One. But he did not go alone. A band of heroes accompanied him. Among them, a mighty sage named Serenica. Veronica, Serena, your friend here is the luminary reborn. And together, you are the reincarnation of his companion. As for Mordekaiser, I suspect that it is his darkness that your friend, the latest in the line of luminaries, was born to banish. You must defeat him. The fate of our world depends upon it. Good luck.
Did I do all right?
Let's do this.
Now then, laddie.
What's up?
I wasn't going to mention it, but...
You wanna speak with little old me?
Thank you.
Another one bites the dust.
Thank you.
else wants some? Who else wants some?
Wonderful.
Nice!
Thank you. Thank you.
Wonderful.
Let's do this! Let's go!
Thank you. Wonderful. Thank goodness.
Oh, this trudging up hills is playing havoc with my old bones.
Oh, well, don't tire yourself out, darling. We all want to be bright-eyed and bushy-tailed for our big day. Come on, let's call it a night, huh?
So, we'll finally be going up to Yggdrasil tomorrow. I can't help feeling a little nervous. Serena, why don't you play that song? You know, the one you always used to play when we were children.
Yggdrasil looks so magical at night. It's strange to think that each of our lives is a leaf on one of those branches.
Yeah. And it's really like the old man said. There's some kind of heart in there that all life comes from?
Yes. When someone dies, their leaf withers and falls, and their soul returns to the heart. When someone is born, a new bud blooms on one of the branches.
I suppose it won't be long now until we finally face Mordiggan. Do you think if we can beat him, my father will go back to how he once was? Oh. You play an instrument too, Veronica?
Huh? Mm-mm. No. The High Priest gave it to me. He said it would help us. It belonged to our ancestor, Serenica. She left it behind in Arboria, apparently.
Well, I don't know about the rest of you, but I'm pooped. What do you say we all get some beauty sleep?
Veronica? Hmm? We were born at the same time, so our leaves bloomed at the same time, didn't they? Do you think they'll fall at the same time too?
Hmm, I don't know. You've always been a bit slow, to be honest. But I hope they do.
Thank you.
Well, there's no mistaking it. This is the altar.
Aye, you're not wrong there. Go on, laddie. Get the orbs out. Let's see what happens, shall we?
Of rainbows. It's beautiful. Looks like it's finally time for our date with destiny. Come on, we'd better not keep Yggdrasil waiting.
So this is the heart of Yggdrasil. It's bigger than I thought it would be.
It's the source of all life. It's not exactly going to be small now, is it?
It's so fascinating. I'm sort of scared, but I want to touch it.
Ow! Well, that's not very nice. The naughty thing gave me a shock.
Aye, and so it should. I doubt the World Tree would let any but the one who bears her mark near her holiest of holies. After all, only he can wield the weapon destined to dispel the darkness. The Sword of Light. Now, laddie, it's time to reach into the heart of Yggdrasil and claim your birthright. Only you can do it. Only you can save our world.
Damn you, Jasper! How did you find us?
Find you? Did you witless vermin not realize I was following you all along?
What was that?
Now, princess, such boorish behavior hardly befits one of your station. Do you not see that you are utterly powerless to stop me? Tremble before me. Tremble with gratitude. Your sacrifice shall pave the way for my ascent to glory. Come, Luminary, all of you, on your feet. The Tree of Life shall be your place of death. Your journey ends here.
Time to duck and dive!
Yeah!
Deary me!
Pathetic worms!
Can't get through that aura. What is it?
It's a power the like of which we've never seen. Could he be? Surely not. Oh.
So this is the heart of Yggdrasil. Whosoever controls it, controls the world. Or so they say.
Not one step further, Jasper. Now you see it with your own eyes, sire. He is no longer himself. The darkness has him entirely in its thrall. How long he has deceived us, I do not know, but deceive us he has. Jasper is a traitor to Heliodor and to the world! Confess, scoundrel! Just how cheaply did you sell your soul? On second thought, spare me your wretched excuses. In the name and presence of His Majesty, I pronounce you guilty. Prepare to face your punishment.
You have served me well, Hendrik.
Your Majesty. What is the meaning of this?
Jasper, it seems you have snared us a luminary. Very impressive.
It is an honor to serve you, as always.
Lord Mordegon.
The king was... he was Mordegon all along.
Now, Luminary, you are in my power. And soon, your power will belong to me. unlocks Yggdrasil's heart. And this blade is the fabled Sword of Light. Not very fitting for the Lord of Shadows.
The Sword of Light! What has he done?
Almighty Yggdrasil, source of all life,
what's the matter, dearie? Can't you sleep?
No, Mum.
You're still upset about your little fight with Gemma, eh?
She started it. She hit me for no reason. All I did was draw eyebrows on Sandy. Oi, don't laugh. Look at this great big lunch he's given me.
I see it. And I saw the one on her head too. You gave her that, didn't you?
Yeah.
Now you listen to me, my lad. There'll be plenty of times in your life when people upset you and you feel like lashing out. But no matter how much it hurts, and no matter how much you want to hurt them back, you don't go looking for revenge. You do what's right.
I want to be friends with Gemma again, Mum. What should I do?
Why, you talk to her, of course, you big silly. Ask her what she was feeling and why she did what she did. Try to see things from her point of view. Once you've done that, the rest is easy. You just smile and hold out your hand. That's my boy. Now, time for bed.
Night-night, Mum.
Night-night, son. Don't you worry about a thing now. It'll all be all right in the morning. Good night. Sleep tight, child of Yggdrasil. The sun
It is sleeping, and the night is still. The stars, they watch over you with twinkling eyes to ward off the darkness till dawn arrives.
Have you found him yet?
Not yet, Master. Our forces have scoured the four corners of the world, but the Luminary is nowhere to be found.
He is dead, then. Good. If that is the case, then this world is mine.
Mordiggan has played his hand. The game is all but won. A shroud of deepest darkness has eclipsed the shining sun. And yet, amid the shadows, glimmer tiny specks of light. Faint, flickering flames that rage against the coming of the night. How can such sparks of hope remain when darkness rules the land? Now evil reigns supreme. Who has the strength to take a stand?
What happened? Where am I? I'm alive. But how?
Sylv! Sylv! Oh, thank goodness you're all right. Sylv! Stay with me, Sylv! Come on, pull yourself... Oh, there you are. You all right, Sylv?
Sure, Davy, honey. I was just getting a little air. Being cooped up in that cabin was driving me crazy, you know?
Oh, come on, Sylv. Cheer up, will ya? I don't think I'm gonna take much more of this moping.
That day, when Mordiggan... There was nothing I could do. He was just too powerful. I thought it was the end for me. For all of us. But this is worse than death. To wake up and find everybody gone and the world consumed by darkness. I'm sorry, Davy, but I can't do this. I know I should feel lucky to be alive, but without the others, I'm nothing. Nobody.
Right. That's enough of that. Have you lost your bleeding marbles? Since when were them mates of yours the types to let some Lord of Shadows numpty get the better of them, eh? How about you have a bit of bleeding faith in them like you used to? Or did you think saving the world was going to be easy or something?
Oh, Davey, darling. You're right. If a slip of a thing like me was able to get out of that tangle with Mordagon alive, then the others must have done too. And here I am feeling sorry for myself instead of getting out there and trying to find them. What would Veronica and Eric say if they saw me like this?
That's more bleeding like it. It's good to have you back, me old mucker.
Oh, it's good to be back, believe me. Now, enough chit-chat. It's time for action. We need to make land at the nearest port and find out just how much of a mess the world is in. And once we've done that, we can make a start on fixing it.
Sounds like a plan, Sylv. Nearest harbor to here would be over in Gondolia. I'll plot a course right away.
That sounds just perfect, honey. Anchors away! Hoist the mainsail! Gondolia, here we come!
Aye, aye, Captain.
Day? Don't worry, hun. It happens to us all.
Oh. You're one of those minstrel types, are you? Look, if it's money you want, you'd better go and hassle someone else. I haven't got a penny to give you.
Sorry, darling. No can do. It's against my policy to leave people all alone. They look as down in the dumps as you do. Look, why don't you just tell me what's on your mind?
A problem shared is a problem halved.
That's better. Now we can talk properly. Silvando, entertainer extraordinaire at your service.
Right. Well, my name's Tetsu. I'm a blacksmith from Hotto, though I haven't been back a long old while. I'll tell you my story if you really want, but I'm warning you, it doesn't have a happy ending. After all those years away, I thought it was time for me to finally head home, see how my mother was doing, you know. But then the minute I set out on my journey, Yggdrasil fell. That just made me even more desperate to get back, of course. I was so worried about her. I managed to make it as far as Gondolia, but then my luck finally ran out. My luggage was stolen by a gang of thieves who've been terrorizing the town. The Beastly Boys, they call themselves. I can't make the journey to Hotto without all my things, especially not the lilies of the valley I brought for my mother. They're her favorite flower. I wanted to give them to her to say, well, to say sorry for being away for so long, for leaving her all alone.
Oh, honey, believe me, I know exactly how you feel. Fear not, friend. Your mother will get her flowers. Tave and I will make sure of that. All you need to do is tell us where we can find these beastly boys.
Oh, well, if you're sure. There are two merchants, brothers, who run establishments in the southern part of town. I've heard that the Beastly Boys have been hanging around causing trouble at the older one's stall.
A stall in the south of town, huh? All right, we'll be back before you know it. Tave, darling, let's roll!
Wait! Look, I appreciate you trying to help me, but these are real thugs we're talking about here. And no offense, but you're just an entertainer, right? I wouldn't want you getting hurt.
Oh, don't you worry about me, sweetie. I'm more than just a pretty face, you know?
Get him, boys!
Won't you show?
Dolby King!
Fabulous!
Leave it to me!
Oh no! Don't look!
Take this!
Get in! Dolby King! Lovely jubbly.
Now, if you don't mind.
What we gonna do with this horrible lot then, Sylve?
Well, beastly they may be, but they're not exactly the dangerous thugs we heard about. I can barely swing a sword. What's your story, boys, huh?
We didn't start out as criminals. We were fishermen. And very happy fishermen at that. But after Yggdrasil fell, we couldn't take the boats out anymore. Have you seen the sea lately? It's swarming with monsters.
Things were just impossible. Most days, we barely had anything to eat.
The world might as well have ended that day. Lost our families. Lost everything. And no one came to help us. So we had to choose between a life of crime or starving to death. And that's no choice at all.
Watch closely, darlings. This is just an ordinary steel pike, yes?
Mm-hmm.
Think again. From arms to... Bon appetit, beastly boys. Eat your fill and forget your wicked ways. You'll be beaming again before you know it.
Wait! Who? Who are you?
Me? Oh, nobody. Just someone who likes to see people smile.
goodness. They're still in one piece. Now I can go home to my mother with my head held high. Thank you, Mr. Silvando. Oh, here. It's not much, but I want you to have these.
Oh, Tetsu, darling. Whatever they are, I'm sure they're wonderful. You're such a sweetie.
Honestly, you deserve much more. Come and visit me in Hotto sometime. I'll be able to thank you properly. Now, I'd better be off. I tell you to be careful, but I've got a feeling you'll be just fine. Bye for now.
Ta-da! Here, you're right, Silv.
Oh, I'm better than all right, darling. I found it. My purpose in life. You know how I've been so down in the dumps thinking about all the despair and suffering in the world? Well, if that's what's making me so unhappy, there's only one thing to do about it. Get out there and fix the problem. Help make people happy again. Just because I can't save the world with some grand heroic gesture, that doesn't mean I can't do it one smile at a time.
That's my Silv. I'm with you all the way.
We heard everything you just said.
It's them tea leaves from before. I hope they ain't spoiling for another fight. Didn't they learn a lesson first time round?
You have to let us come with you. You have to let us help people. We're done with our life of crime, thanks to you.
You want to tag along? Well, I hope you understand it won't be easy. I can't guarantee you'll get home in one piece.
We don't care!
Well, in that case, welcome aboard, darlings!
Yes!
Now, as luck would have it, I've got you all a welcome gift. Here, take one each now. Don't be greedy.
Wow.
Oh, they're simply fabulous. Darlings, you look splendid.
I don't get it, Silv. What are they?
They're the presents dear old Tetsu gave us. If we're going to be traveling around spreading happiness and laughter, we'll need to look the part, no? All right, we're all set. Let's get out there and bring some sunshine back into the world. Silvando's super special smile-spreading parade starts right here.
Yeah!
Here we go!
Oh,
Woo! Well, that was easy.
Now that's beastly.
Go, my king.
Leave it to me.
Lovely jubbly!
Thank you.
Arriba! Hey!
Oh, hi!
Oi, Sylph!
Wonderful.
We did it, darlings!
Leave it to me.
Thank you.
Leave it to me.
Is that all you got?
My child?
Ah!
chop!
Is the party over already?
Leave it to me.
Don't look!
This is kind of fun.
That was easy.